Warning, this video may cause motion sickness, nausea, headache, dizziness, or disorientation. If you have a history of migraines, vertigo, or elevated anxiety, please skip the allotted time. Thank you, and please enjoy the video. Good luck. Hello everybody, this is Kevin, and as you can see, we're back with another episode of Star Fox 64 playthrough. We're in the asteroid field again, except this time, the blue warp gates that we basically skipped on last time, we're going to be taking. Those lead you towards the middle planets, so yeah, you know, I mean, there's not much else I can describe about it. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Remember, this is right after the checkpoint, before the boss of the level. So you have to make sure to get all these warps, and it can be pretty tough, actually. So if you don't get it at first, don't feel bad. So it's actually pretty trippy, so get ready for a real ride.
My God, it's full of stars.
Whoa. That was trippy, but it's not even the end of it, folks. Yeah, that's right. Just in case you were wondering what that was, that's the clip from the movie 2001 A Space Odyssey, and it's a Stargate sequence that happens near the end of the movie. The voice, if you did happen to watch it and not suffer a seizure like I did, anyway, is mine. I just basically said the same thing, looped it over 3 times, and then just played it back with basically a second of, you know, difference to each of the times they were saying a word. But anyway, yeah, so this is the actual level, you know. Like I said, though, it is pretty trippy. As you can see, everything's really bright. It's hard to see your enemies, and you can get a really high kill count here if you use your bombs. I really decide not to, because I demonstrated last time how overused bombs can be. Overused and overpowered. So, I'm really trying not to here. I do up here just because it's, well, there's so many, I just, is it up here? No, it's later down. But anyway, yeah, I do use it a little bit later on, just because there's so many meteorite things that I couldn't resist. Yeah, but I really like this area because it's so trippy and just, oh, what the hell. Well, I use my bomb somewhere in there, whatever. But anyway, yeah, that's how you get to the middle planets from the meteorite. So, asteroid belt. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy that little bit, but we're actually gonna move on to the next planet as well, because that was, you know, with the cut in there and everything, even with that clip, which is like about 2 minutes. That was still only about 4 minutes of actual video. So, this is Katina, and I actually really like this planet. So the reason is because I want to spoil it, but let's get in there first. You know, let's get in there. Yeah. So it's a reunion. So obviously we're meeting someone here.
Hang on, guys. Help is on the way.
Whoa! It's a dog, and his name is Bill. Actually, the dog's name is Bill Gray. He's presumed to be named after the gray bulldog, English bulldog. But his original colors used to have a grayish tint to his fur. But yeah, as for background, he and Fox went to the Corneria Academy together to learn how to fly. But eventually, of course, Fox left to form the Star Fox Elite Team. And while Bill stayed on and eventually, you know, got to basically become lead of his two own units, the Husky unit and the Bulldog unit, I believe. I'm not sure about the second one.
Man, there's just no end to
now, anyway, this is basically a space fight on this planet for this part. You're flying around, you're shooting ships. My suggestion is use your auto lock-on bomb, because if you don't, that's what happens if you shoot down one of yours and you don't get a kill count for it. So, yeah. Also, when you get killed, 10 kills, yeah, as you can tell, you become quite the pilot. So, oh, what's this? Enemy mothership approaching?
Go find your own target.
So, yeah. I like this level a lot. And, the reason is because not only do they introduce a new character, but, you know, it's just, you fly around, and it's just a free-for-all. You know, you can shoot everything if you want. I'm being a little conservative, you know, but as you can see, there's a mothership. And, if anyone who knows this reference, knows why I like this planet, I mean, it's pretty obvious. It's an old reference, it's an old movie, and, you can see here, they kind of reference it here even more with this shot. You know, it has Will Smith in it, had, that guy from Jurassic Park, Goldblum, I don't remember his first name, I think that's his last name, you know, but, for its time, it was a pretty good movie. My mom actually loves that movie a lot, but, I like it just because of this level. I was like, oh man, no way, they did not, so, yeah, but, anyway, so yeah, as you can see, after the mothership comes out, there's a lot more of these guys. So, and they usually travel in kind of like in little packs. As you can see, you usually see two or three next to each other. So it's beneficial to you to lock on and, you know, aim and kill them. If you don't, it's not that big of a deal, to be honest. You really, this level doesn't require you to have a kill count to get a mission accomplished. You know, but if you want that medal, I think you have to get over like 150 or something like that. Which actually isn't hard, it's just basically requires patience. If you don't attack the mothership and you basically just go after these guys, you can get that kill count pretty easily. So, yeah. But, anyway, for the mothership, what you have to do, obviously, is attack the small things that come down. There you go. The small hatches that come down. Now, you can throw bombs at them, and that'll pretty much take them out pretty good, actually. And then you just get a few shots in, like I do here, and you can even get two in one go. So, it's pretty good. But, yeah, as you can see, this is... it's very hectic. Don't! Good job, Peppy. Good job. What a hair. What a hair. What a guy. That's not that bright. But, yeah, as for Bill, he makes an appearance on this planet, and then one more, which you could probably guess is it's the next planet, if you succeed in this one in helping them. But, yeah, so this is the part where you finally finish off the mothership, because obviously the coal has appeared. And does anyone else think that looks like a space penis? Ooh, what is that? Gosh! Yeah. It's pretty easy, though. It's a pretty easy planet, I'll be honest with you. It's just a timer type thing. But, yeah, in case anyone was wondering what happened if you failed, here's a clip. pretty accurate, actually. It's almost the exact same thing. But anyway, that was English. Anyway, yeah, so mission accomplished. As you can see, we got 92 kills. So it's not too bad, considering I wasn't really trying to just shoot everything in sight.
Take care, Bot. You too, Bill.
You know. Anyway, so this has been episode 8 of Star Fox 64. You guys have a nice day, and for anyone who couldn't watch that clip, next time.